Hey friends, Amanda here, Bare Bones Living. Welcome back to my garden. And today I wanted to talk to you guys about maximizing your growing space, whatever that might be. For me, this year, I'm growing everything in pots, which I have grown in pots before, but I've never grown like solely in pots. And so it has kind of forced me to start thinking about things differently. And that's what I wanted to talk about. And that is using the space, whatever space you have, to its fullest potential. So there's things like green stocks where you can plant multiple different varieties in each cell and things like that. And that kind of got me thinking. And I have all these pots that I have plants in, but I should really be utilizing these plants or these pots to their fullest potential. So planting multiple heights of things and planting companion plants with each other and just trying to maximize your production in the space that you have. So let me show you a couple of the pots that I've already started doing that in. So in this pot that you see here, this is a pot that I have bought, that I bought this year for my blueberry plants. And so I just transplanted this blueberry, this is a Jersey blueberry plant, into the center of this big pot. And it's going to take a while for this to grow, but this is a very large pot. And while it's growing, I might as well use all this space all around it to grow some other things. So I had some celery starts that I didn't have any more of my grow bags for. So I threw some celery, the last of the celery that I had, around here. And then, sorry, this rosemary, or sorry, not rosemary, lavender is coming over onto me. And then I have three chamomile plants back here. I have three chamomile plants back here as well, because why not, right? It'll just bring in more pollinators, and it'll just give me that many more blossoms. So I had some extra chamomile plants and I stuck them there. So I'm utilizing, I could probably plant even more in here, but this is just the capacity that I can do at the moment. So I started with this one. Let me show you another one. So on top of my hot tub here, I have a couple of bags that I put in my store-bought tomatoes. And in here, in this one, I put some opal basil starts. Let me see if I can get you guys down in there. So there's an opal basil start right there. There's another one down here, and another one over here. Then in this one next to it, this one only has one tomato plant in here. This one obviously has the two tomato plants. This tomato plant here, I put these two, that right there, and there. That is more little celery starts. I put a little butter gem lettuce plant here, and then I put a red leaf lettuce back there. This one with the sweet potato slips, I just left alone because I think that those will be too bushy. But then this tomato back here, again, I put a red leaf lettuce there. That's another celery start. That's another little butter gem. And then there's another one back there. And then over here in this cucumber bag that's starting to attach to my brassicas because it's starting to vine out. So I'm gonna have to support that. I've stuck an endive down in there. Just something to take up that space down there right in front of it. Down in this blueberry pot, we have the blueberry in the middle. And then around this whole edge here, I have basil. And then I have two dill plants. I think they're too little. I don't know that you can actually see them. There's two dill plants in there as well. So now I have all these tomato bags here, and then I have two more pepper bags around the back side of the hot tub here that I'm thinking I should be utilizing these better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, I have starts that I haven't sold, and I'm just, there's too much going on with the move and things like that. I'm not really trying to sell very much, and I don't want those plants to go to waste. So I think what I'm going to do is take, I have lots of basils that I have left. I'm going to stick some basils in some of these. I have lettuce starts that I'm going to stick in some of these. And then I think in a couple of them, I'm going to start some carrot seeds and see how that does. And we're just going to get these bags filled up as much as we can and get our plant starts used up as much as we can and not waste anything, hopefully. Okay, so in here with my black raspberry plant, I put in my last couple of plugs of endive lettuce, just bordering around the plant. And those will get bigger and bushier. Back here, I put parsley. I think I put 5 parsley plants. I tried to put 5 in each bag when it came to like herbs and things. So I think there's 5 parsley plants in there, and that has 2 tomatoes in it, which is already gonna get a little bit crowded, but that's okay. We're working with what we got. In with my blackberries, I put the last of my Italian dandelion leaf lettuce. There's a couple of really small ones back there. And then here, oh, looks like I broke that while planting. So this is a Roma plant, and in here I put some Thai basil, and I'll let, again, 5 of those, and I'll let these grow for like a week or something, and then to kind of establish, and then I'll trim them back to just this so that they start to bush out. But I like to give them like a week to settle in. In this, I believe, is also aroma. Yeah, this is my aroma. I put 5 sage plants all around. Back in this is a Dr. Weich's, and this has the lime basil in it. And those grow much slower than the other ones, but there's still 5 of those in there. Then over here, this is another Roma. This has some more parsley in it. You can see one down there. There's 5 parsley in there. Behind it is another Dr. Weich's, and I have opal basil. 5 opal basils in there. Next to that is a Paul Robeson, and I have dill plants in there. And these are bouquet dill. I know that they look really small right now because they are, but they're also bouquet dill, and so they're not going to get super tall. So I figured they would be pretty good for a pot. Up here in front of that, this is, I think, another Roma. Yep. That's another Roma plant, and I put endive lettuce in there. And there's more than 5 in there. They're looking a little sad right now. I'm about to water them. Don't worry. And then this, I have endive in here too. And this is a potato leaf tomato. It's that weird, let's see. Rarikawai tomato. Don't know how to pronounce that. Don't know if I'm doing that right. Then behind that one is another same tomato plant as this one. And in here, I sprinkled, I surface sowed some Scarlet Nantes carrots. Then next to that, I had in my Floridad tomato, I sprinkled some purple carrots. And then in front of that, in another Floridad, I had some pelleted carrot seeds that I planted in here. Or no, this is Marvel Four Seasons that I surface sowed in here. Because I didn't have that. That's my favorite lettuce, and I haven't planted any of that this year. Then in this one is the one that I did the pelleted pelleted carrots, Bolero carrots, and then this is the one that has the purple carrots in it. So this has Scarlet Nantes. This one, honestly, guys, I don't remember. I might have skipped this one. I don't think there's anything in that one. That one. Yeah, I don't think there's anything in this one. And then over here in my peppers, you can see I topped my jalapeno pepper, and I topped one of my poblano peppers. This one was still looking a little puny, so I was trying to let that one grow up. But in with my jalapeno, I have two cinnamon basils and two opal basils. And then in with my poblano peppers, I put two oregano plants. And then over here with my ground cherries, my one is looking very sad. I'm hoping it's just lack of water, but this one looked like that one just last week, but now you can see it's nice and happy, so I'm hoping this one bounces back too. But this is all endive lettuce in here. So I'm really happy to get those plants put into pots and things that I can take with me, and they're not going to waste because I'm not selling them, and I'm actually going to get to use them. I know that some of these things are going to get a little too crowded, and we're going to be swimming in a lot of herbs, which is great, because if you guys watch my Azure hauls, I actually had to buy parsley and oregano and thyme this year, and I shouldn't have had to because I was just too lazy to chop it and dehydrate it. So that won't happen this year, God willing, because I got a lot of herbs going on here, which I'm happy about. It's going to be a lot of work, and hopefully it'll be worth it. But I thought this would be a fun experiment, see how all these things grow. I know I put the lettuces really close together. I like growing my lettuces that close together because I think that they grow up nicer real close together with like the support of their growing buddy next to them. But I'm really happy with the work that I've gotten done. I think that these will be mutually beneficial to one another for pest control, for shade, things of that nature. I'm excited to see how those carrots do since they don't do well in heat, but everyone says that they're good to grow together, and hopefully the tomatoes will provide them enough shade that they can germinate and grow just fine. So we'll figure that out together. And then also a couple of those pots that I, two of the pots are the deepest pots that I have with dirt. So I think they'll be okay, but I think one of them is kind of shallow. So that will restrict the growth of the carrot slightly, but it's better than nothing, right? And it's all about learning. So I'm really excited to get this done. I'm excited to share it with you guys. And I hope that you guys get inspired to grow things that grow at different levels and things that are mutually beneficial to each other to maximize what you can get out of one pot. I've just maximized my harvest tenfold at least. So if you guys enjoyed this, please give it a thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, please do that and hit that notification button so that you don't miss any of my next videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys for stopping by today and joining in on our journey here at Bare Bones Living. We'll catch you on the next one.